Assalamualaikum dear students, I hope you are all fine. Today we will read another chapter of your matric class English, which is The Inheritors. This is a list of the chapters, and today we are going to read the chapter number 17, The Inheritors. So let's get started. Let's start with the text. A poor farmer had two sons, Azam and Mozam. Their mother had died in their childhood. So this is the story about two brothers who are Azam and Mozam, whose father was a poor farmer, and their mother had died. Now their father also died, and the boys inherited his property, which consisted of a cow, a dead palm tree, and a blanket. So now their father has also died, and the property which his father has left behind is a cow, a dead palm tree, and a blanket. Azam, the elder brother, was very greedy and clever, but his younger brother, Mozam, was simple and trusting. Azam suggested that they should divide the property left by their late father. So Azam was the elder brother. He was a very greedy person. He was clever, whereas Mozam was simple and trusting. And Azam has suggested that they should divide the property left behind by their father. How shall we divide the cow, for instance? Asked Mozam. Cut it into two. Now, you know, Mozam is, you know, asking his brother Azam that how will they, you know, divide the cow into two. No, stupid, answered Azam. We shall just divide it verbally. For instance, the front part of the cow, which is the better part, shall be yours, while the rear part shall be mine. Agreed? Oh yes, thank you very much. Mozam was delighted with the generosity of his elder brother. So now Azam has suggested that the, you know, front part of the cow will belong to, you know, Mozam, and the rear part will belong to Azam. Similarly, the top of the dead palm, which you cannot climb, shall be mine, while the lower part, that is the trunk, shall be yours. Agreed? Yes, agreed, answered Mozam cheerfully. And what about the blanket? Now there is another suggestion about the dead division of the dead palm tree. Azam has suggested that the top of the, you know, the part that is top of the dead palm would belong to Mozam, will belong to Azam, and the lower part would belong to Mozam. Now this is about the division of the blanket. It shall be mine only from the sunset to sunrise, that's only during the night. It shall be yours for the whole day. Agreed, said Mozam, thinking happily that it was a fair division. Now Azam has suggested that the blanket would belong to you from sunset to sunrise to sunset, whereas for all in night it will belong to me. It will be mine. Now Mozam would feed the cow, and Azam would milk it. He would not give a drop of milk to Mozam. Instead, he would praise Mozam for looking after the cow and feeding it so well. It pleased the innocent younger brother so much that he gave even more grass to the cow, and the cow gave more milk. Now what happens, because, you know, the front part of the cow belongs to, you know, Mozam, that is why he is bound to, you know, feed the cow. So he is, you know, giving it grass, and you know, Azam is not, you know, giving a drop of milk to his brother Mozam, and in return he just praises Mozam for, you know, taking care of the cow very well, and, you know, the Mozam is very happy with this praise. In the same manner, Mozam regularly watered the dead palm tree. When the dates were ripe for picking, Azam climbed the tree and picked all the fruit. He did not offer even a single date to his younger brother. Of course, he praised him for looking after the tree so well. Mozam was quite content with it. Same is the case with the dead palm tree. You know, Azam would not give a single date to Mozam. Here comes the third object of the property, which is a blanket. As regards the blanket, Mozam had no use for it because it was not during the day. At night, when it grew cold, he would shiver while Azam enjoyed a deep, comfortable sleep under the warm blanket. This went on for some time. An old man of the village noticed how the younger brother was being cheated by the elder brother. One day the old man their house found Mosem was feeding the cow. So in dream, Mosem, you know, a blanket was useless for Mosem because it was too hot in dream, and so it was useless for Mosem. Whereas Azam enjoyed a deep sleep, enjoyed a deep slumber in night, and on the other hand, Mosem was shivering entire night. Now here comes the climax of the story. So an old man comes and he sees Mosem feeding the cow. "Why are you feeding the cow?" said the old man. "Because the front part is mine," answered Mosem. "And who gets the milk?" "My brother, because the rear part belongs to him," answered the Mosem innocently. "Does he give you any milk?" asked the old man. "Then you are a fool. You look after the cow and feed her, and your brother gets all the milk. But what can I do?" said Mosem helplessly. "This is all according to agreement between us." So now old man comes and he whispers something in the ear of Mosem. He says, "Come here and listen to me." The old man whispered something in his ear. So now old man is suggesting something to Mosem, that what should he do in order to get his due share from his greedy brother. Next morning, as usual, Azam began to milk the cow. Mosem also came with a short stick and hit the cow's head. "The cow moved this way and that." "Stop it," shouted Azam. "Don't you see I am milking the cow? Don't disturb her." "I am only hitting the front part, which is mine," said Mosem. "I shall do what I like with my part of the cow." So Mosem is, hitting the cow, hitting the front part of the cow with a stick, and he says that it belongs to me. So, and I am authorized to do whatever I like to do with it. Azam was a very clever boy. He guessed that somebody had advised Mosem to do that. "All right, I shall give you half the milk, and now stop beating the cow. And you must also share it in the feeding of the cow," said Mosem. And Azam had to agree to it. Now, Azam had known that that somebody must have suggested Mosem about my deal. That is why he has now offered Mosem to take half of the milk, and he has also agreed to feed the cow and help his brother in feeding the cow. After a few days, Azam climbed the dead palm tree to pick ripe dates. He had hardly collected a handful of dates when he heard the sound of an axe striking on the tree. So Mosem had once again come with an axe, and he was cutting the lower part of the dead palm tree, and he argued that it belonged to me, that is I can do whatever I liked. So Azam said that I will give you half of the dates. You must stop cutting the tree. You must stop cutting the dead palm tree. But Mosem said that you have to help me in watering the tree as well. And Azam agreed. The same night, when Azam came to take the blanket, he found that it was wet. So now, Mosem had made the blanket wet, Azam is asking Mosem that what have you done to the blanket, and Mosem claims that it's because it belonged to me in the daytime, so I can do whatever I like with it. And Azam said, "Very well, dear brother. From tomorrow night, we shall." Share the blanket and we will sleep together. And so this is the short summary of this chapter, the Inheritors. You may read it. So this was all about the chapter number 17, which is the Inheritors. Inshallah, in our next lecture we will do another topic. Till then, Allah Hafiz, and take a good care of yourself.